Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to Learn Linux TV. In today's video, what we're going to do is check out mainline kernel builds in Ubuntu. What mainline kernel builds enable you to do is have newer kernels on your Ubuntu system than you might have access to otherwise. But why would you want to change the kernel? Well, there's actually a few different reasons why you might want to do this. When it all comes down to it, the main benefit here is that newer kernel builds have newer features. They also have newer drivers as well. But if you are not using a newer kernel, then you're not benefiting from those new features. Now, to be fair, if your current kernel works just fine, there's no reason to change it. But if there's a feature in the newer kernel that you want to take advantage of, then mainline kernel builds are a great way to do that. If you are a software developer, maybe you might want to test your application against a newer Linux kernel just to see how the performance might be on that kernel. That's also a very good use case. However, a more common reason why you might want to benefit from a mainline kernel build is to take advantage of newer hardware. If you have a brand new piece of hardware that just came out, chances are the current version of the Linux kernel that you have installed might not have the drivers that are required to support that piece of hardware. So by installing a mainline kernel build, what you could do is benefit from newer drivers, which might actually get that piece of hardware working. And considering that newer Linux kernels have newer hardware drivers as well, well, this could be a very good way to enable hardware that otherwise wouldn't really work all that well. So what I'll do in today's video is show you not only how to benefit from these new kernels, but I'll also show you how to install and use the mainline kernel app, which will help you better facilitate mainline kernel builds on your system. And you know what? I'm very excited to get started, so why don't we do exactly that? As always, there's going to be time codes in the description down below if you want to jump to a specific section. Otherwise, I'll meet you in the next section and we'll get started. So here I am on my Ubuntu desktop. This footage is actually being recorded from my Thelio desktop. So what you're seeing is screen output directly from the hardware. This installation of Ubuntu 2204 is completely fresh. I installed it just a few minutes ago, and I've already updated it, so I'm ready to go. So anyway, I'll open up a terminal. Let's check out the version of the kernel that we have right now. So currently, we have kernel 5.15. Now, I forgot to mention this during the intro, but a quick disclaimer that I need to give you guys is that I'm not responsible if your system is unbootable if something goes wrong as a part of this process. I don't suspect that anything will go wrong. These are kernels that are built by Ubuntu developers themselves, but all things considered, we really should be prepared for any uncertainties that could happen, and a backup is the least you could do. Anyway, with that out of the way, as you can see, we have kernel 5.15, so how exactly do we go about getting a hold of these mainline kernels and getting them installed? Well, let's see what the process looks like. So what I'm going to do is add a special PPA to my system here. And to do that, I'll run sudo add-apt-repository. And the repository that I want to add is located at PPA colon. And I'm just going to type out the URL here. So the command that you see on the screen right now will help you add the mainline app to your system. That's what this repository actually contains. So I'll press enter. And then I'll type in my super secret password. And it's going to give me some basic information here about the repository. I'll just go ahead and press enter to continue with adding it to the system. And we can see that it's already updating the package repository index, so I don't have to run sudo apt-update or anything like that. So we should be able to search for the mainline app and install it. And as you can see, the mainline app is available. So I searched for the mainline app, and now I was able to find it. So let's go ahead and install it. We'll install the mainline package just like that. And I'll press enter again to accept the defaults, just a few dependencies that are necessary for this app to run. Nothing unusual here. And now it's installed. So we shouldn't actually need this terminal window anymore, so I'll just close that. And if I go to the Applications menu here on Ubuntu, and I think it's going to be located on the second page, and here it is, the Ubuntu Mainline Kernel Installer. It's right there in the menu, so let's launch it. So at this point, it's just going to refresh itself and index which kernels are available as part of this service. Oh, sorry. I was just consulting my own book, actually. You know, that's something that I do from time to time because unlike what many of you might think, I don't memorize everything that I teach you guys. Sometimes I actually look at my own book if I want to remember how to do something that I don't do every day. But since I'm on the subject of this book, check it out. Mastering Ubuntu Server 4th Edition, written by yours truly. It's available right now, and I think you're going to love it. So if you're looking for an Ubuntu book to teach you everything that you need to know when it comes to managing real Ubuntu servers, check it out. So definitely check out the book. I would really appreciate it. Anyway, let's get back to the video. And now we're finished. So what we have right here is a list of kernels that we can install as part of the service. As you can see, there's actually quite a few. We could even go to an older version if we wanted to. I don't know why you might want to do that, but you can do that if you wish. But at the very top, we have Linux kernel 5.19.11 available, which as of the time I'm recording this video, that's the latest mainline kernel build that's available as part of this service. Now, obviously, it takes me a while to edit footage and get it released. So by the time you're watching this video, there's probably going to be even newer kernels available. Now, which one should you actually install? Well, what I like to do is open up a web browser. And what I'll do is go to kernel.org. That's the official website for the Linux kernel. So you can go there to find out which versions are available. We already know which versions are available as part of the mainline app, but there's a specific reason why I want to go to the site here. So what this site allows you to do is download source code for the Linux kernel, but that's not actually why I'm asking you to pull up this page. Now you'll notice that we have a number of kernels available here, and the main reason why I wanted you to pull this up was not just to know which versions are available, but actually this will tell you which versions are long-term supported. Unless you have a specific reason to install a particular version of the Linux kernel, I highly recommend that you choose a long-term release. The thing is, though, the latest long-term kernel is kernel 5.15. And actually, that's what we're currently running right now. So we're not going to switch to a kernel that we already have, so let's actually install a different kernel. Then in this case, I'm going to break my own advice and install a kernel that's not a long-term supported kernel, specifically 5.19.11. It is the newest version aside from the one that I have installed, so I'll just go along with that. So I'll choose that kernel right here, and then I'll click install. So now, as you can see, it's in the beginning stage of installing. Now it's asking for my password, so I'll just type that in real quick. And now it's done. At the bottom there, it says installation completed. A reboot is required to use the new kernel. So let's just go ahead and reboot the system then. So it's booting up right now. And by the end of this process, hopefully we'll be running a newer kernel. We could already see that the login screen is a lot larger than I remember it, which probably means that the NVIDIA driver is not being used right now, something that I figured would probably happen. When you have an NVIDIA GPU on your system, you might run into things like these and have to manually reinstall the driver. I'm not going to worry so much about that in this video. So I'll just click on my username here, and I'll log in. So, weird resolution aside, let's just go ahead and open up a terminal. And if I check the version of the kernel that I'm running, as you can see, I'm using kernel 5.19.11. So, it looks like the process of installing a mainline kernel actually worked out just fine. So, as you can see right here, you might run into some issues if you have an NVIDIA driver. That was something that I was actually expecting to happen because when you are dealing with the NVIDIA driver, then you can't really expect everything to work straight out of the box unless you're using the kernel that's configured by default in Ubuntu. And because I'm not using that kernel, then I'm also not benefiting from the NVIDIA driver as packaged by Ubuntu. But I do indeed have kernel 5.19 now. as you can see right there. So when it comes to installing a mainline kernel build, well, the process worked out just fine. NVIDIA aside, I have the new kernel. As far as switching back to the previous kernel, especially if you run into a situation like this, what you could do is you can restart your system. I'll just do that right now. And then when it comes back up, we could press escape to select a different kernel, which is exactly what I plan on doing right now to hopefully get my resolution back. And here it is. So I'll select the advanced options right here, the second item on the list. And of course, we have the kernel that I've just installed. But here we have the previous kernel, the one that came with Ubuntu itself. It was actually updated, which is why I have it here twice. They release new versions of kernels all the time. Anyway, I'll select that kernel. And now I'm back to my previous kernel. So now you know how to switch between kernels if you go ahead and install a mainline kernel. But as you can see, we were able to get back to the system the way it was before. And if I wanted to remove that kernel, the one that we installed that didn't work out quite well on account of the fact that I am running an NVIDIA GPU, what we could do is just reopen the mainline kernel installer app yet again. It's going to refresh. It does that every time you open it. And then we have the 5.19 kernel installed. Let's go ahead and uninstall it. So that way, when I reboot, it's automatically going to reboot into the kernel that actually does work. And now I've removed kernel 5.19 from my system. And NVIDIA issues aside, you can see that the mainline app is actually really helpful. If I had a GPU that utilized open source drivers, I wouldn't have run into any of those problems. But at the very least, I have this mainline installer right here. So if at any time in the future I would like to try out a new release of the Linux kernel, I could definitely do that. So there you go. In today's video, we went over mainline kernel builds, and I hope you found this content helpful. If you did, then please click that like button. I would really appreciate it. And I have some awesome videos coming very soon, so please subscribe if you haven't already done so. Anyway, thank you guys so much for checking out this video. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next video.